Hi, hello students, welcome to SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. Now we're gonna see the next class in geography. Kindly follow our channel, subscribe and watch our playlist to get all the courses in detail as usual, my dear friend. Today we're gonna start our class about a classification of rocks. Until that, we shall start every class with a good motivational quote. As you should remember this, my dear friend, when someone is going through storm, your silence presence is powerful than a million of empty words. You can see the people uttering many empty words and uttering something else, and whatever the problems, anything you go through, nobody can understand, but your silence is what means a lot, and it is powerful than millions of words. And just for uttering just for the sense of uttering some words, which is unnecessarily. So better weapon is silence, my dear friends. Okay, we shall go to the classification of rocks. As usual, classification of rocks, we will see the three types of rocks and how they are formed and what are all their importance, such as igneous rocks, sediment rocks and also metamorphic rocks. All the three types of rocks will be seen together and also the details. Let's have an image overview, my dear friends, how these rock formations have been happening. As usual, everything starts from the magma stage. The magma is the molten form of rocks that are present underneath the earth. It are also mostly in a we can see here below the lithosphere it is present, and here the molten form whenever it rises. While on the way to rise inside the earth itself, sometimes it consolidation is happening and also it solidifies to form rocks called igneous rock, that too is intrusive. What is intrusive? Intrusive means it is crystallization of magma and inside the earth, so that it forms as igneous rocks. If it overcomes to the surface of earth as lava, as seen here, it comes out of the earth as lava and then it cools down to form igneous rocks as extrusive rocks. It is called as consolidation. So as usual, magma is solidified to igneous rocks, and also two types. One is intrusive and extrusive. Intrusive means it is inside the earth, and extrusive means it's outside the earth, it solidifies. This igneous rock, to the time period, it faces many environmental features and also atmospheric changes. It faces everything else like rain, weathering, air, pressure, everything, and slowly it weathering. It starts weathering and transported to different places, and also again it is deposited. Further, it is a lithification, which means high pressure is mounted on it. Slowly one after other accumulates over and over, and slowly it forms into the sedimentary rocks. After the formation of these sedimentary rocks, it just moves down the earth, and also slowly the higher pressure, temperature, everything keeps on rising. So based on continuous temperature and pressure, it forms into the metamorphic rocks. It is also called as metamorphism. So here this is metamorphism, and these metamorphic rocks soon, due to high temperature, it melts and to form as magma. So now you have a clear idea of how the rocks are formed. Rocks are of three forms: igneous, sedimentary and also metamorphic rocks. Now we shall see one by one with image oriented studies, my dear friend. First, now we will see the igneous rocks. How does this igneous rocks are formed? Igneous rocks are formed through cooling and solidification of molten rock form. See, you know, the molten rock form means magma, which is inside the earth, and as usually it just cools down and solidifies to form this igneous rocks. And also the magma, when it reaches the surface, we call it as lava. Never confuse with magma and lava. So magma is inside the earth in molten stage. When the molten stage come out of the earth, the same molten stage is called as a lava. And next we can see the properties of these igneous rocks here. These are mostly crystalline in texture, which means which will be much more stronger and stiff. Now we shall see the igneous rocks are of two types. Based on their chemical composition, they are divided further two types, and also based on their origin, they are divided into further two types. We will see everything all together. Based on the chemical composition, we know the chemical composition means one is acidic and another is basic. So the acidic rocks is also having high proportion of silica. So now remember this in your exam, this may be asked: the high proportion of silica is present in igneous rock, what type of rocks it is? It is acidic rocks, and also it is less dense and lighter in color. This is the texture and also structure of it. So acidic rocks is less dense and also lighter in color. Now when we see the basic rocks. It is basic igneous rocks based on their chemical composition we are seeing. It is higher proportion of basic oxides are present, like Fe and Al, which means aluminium and iron oxides are present. Now remember, the question may be asked, which is the rocks having higher amount of iron oxides and aluminium oxide in igneous rock types, which means it is a basic. See, these points you must be much more careful. And also here, denser and darker in color. Now remember, acidic means it is lighter and less dense. And also here, basic rocks are denser and darker in color. Now this is the thing we must know about chemical composition of these igneous rocks. Bit more be careful of the composition. Silica means it is acidic. And also silica, acidic means Ca is ending here, silica, so that you can remember. Iron and aluminium oxide, it gives a basic solution. Next we can see here, based on the origin of these igneous rocks, further we divide into igneous rocks are two types. One is intrusive, other is extrusive. Intrusive means, as I had shown here, inside the earth, these igneous rocks or molten magma is solidified. Due to crystallization, it is called as intrusive rocks. And also next thing we're gonna see, extrusive rocks. Extrusive rocks means which are solidified outside the earth because of the exposure to the environment or atmosphere. Now we shall see these intrusive rocks. Intrusive rocks are also called as plutonic rocks. Plutonic rocks means they are formed inside the crust. We know that it is formed inside the crust. Mostly plutonic means it is crystalline rocks, and also slowly it is cooled, because as you know here, when it is exposure to the atmosphere, it has a rapid cooling phenomena. But these intrusive rocks are not exposure to this atmosphere, so it is slowly cooled inside the earth. And also this formation of plutonic rocks, for example, we can see this batholith. And also when we see the volcanic landforms and these things, we can see this batholith and these things also. There you can understand in a clear idea. We shall see the what are the two types of plutonic rocks. Here you can see granite and gabbros, or I will show this image my dear friend. After understanding this theory, we will show the images of this also. Granite and gabbro are the types of intrusive rocks. And next we can see here extrusive rocks are volcanic rocks, which means it is formed after cooling of molten lava. See here, lava means it is on the surface of the earth. And also in the form of volcano, it flows over the surface of the earth and it is solidified rapidly due to the presence of atmosphere. And also these are different types of formations, because a lava is not of a one form, it varies place to place. So here lava flows, you can see here lava, sometimes it will be flowing like anything. And also lava sheets, which will be much more liquid, so it cools down like as if sheets. See, one after other, it will be cooling down as sheets. And also next we can see lava plateaus. The best example for our lava plateau in India is a Deccan plateau. And next, if you consider here types of the extrusive rocks or extrusive igneous rocks, here you can see here it is basalt and rhyolite. Okay friend, now you will get a clear idea of what I have explained till now. See here, you learn theory, you learn also the most of this image format also, so that it will be helping you much more clear in examinations, because sometimes you remember the theory notes, sometimes you remember the images. So in your exam, whatever the thing you remember, it will be helping you a lot. See here, we can see here it is intrusive rocks, means which is inside the earth. Slowly the lava extends and comes out and burst, and here it is flowing as ash. And also several rocks has been thrown. These small sizes rocks which are thrown due to the lava explosion is called as pyroclast. You need not study any definitions, my dear friends. If you remember the concept and what is happening there, you can create your own definition with the vocabulary you are having. So here, the small types of stones which are thrown away from this volcano burst is called as pyroclast. And here the sheets of lava is flowing and cooled down as a black, is you can see here black color. It is called as extrusive rocks. And now we shall see here what are all the gases that are emitted, and also particles emitted by the volcano. It forms as volcanic ash and also pumice, which means the small particles is also called as volcanic ash and pumice. And next we can see the extrusive landforms. What are all that? Here you can see it is basalt and rhyolite. As I had explained earlier, you can see here in the extrusive landform which was on the surface of the earth, it is basalt and rhyolite. Here it is the thing, here I am showing here it is basalt and rhyolite. And here we can see intrusive rocks means Here black color sheets are present inside the earth. You know, this is the surface, and inside the earth here you can see the rock forms. It is called as gabbro and granite landforms. And next we can see here here also phenocrylates, which means on the surface it will be found. And next we can see here also plutonic rocks. Means what are all the plutonic rocks? As you had seen earlier, here you can see granite, and also granite, which means quartz, orthoclase, praglion, hornblende, and diorite, gabbro. It has different varieties. We had seen granite and gabbro as intrusive or plutonic rock forms. Here images give you a clear value. And next we can see, we come to the view of sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks means, as I shown earlier, it is accumulation of rocks. Here we can see how they are formed. It is formed by sedimentation process. Sedimentation process means one after other rocks falls and over and slowly it forms into rock form. For here, transformation of sedimentary rocks is called as compaction and cementation. Compaction cementation means you can see the how the normal employees work on building homes. They'll be putting cements one after the over and over. Same process happens here on sedimentary rocks also. This process is called as lithifications. And next we can see the properties of it. It is non-crystalline. It is not much more stronger. If you comparing the strength of the rock forms, igneous is a much more strengthiest rock. And next it comes to the metamorphic rocks, and also final strength is given to sedimentary rocks, which means weakest among the rocks is sedimentary rocks. And also it has different types, both is hard sedimentary rocks and also soft sedimentary rocks. And mostly, see here, the fossil fuels are mostly found in sedimentary rocks. This type of questions can be asked, and much more important for you. Here they will be asking, fossil fuels are found in which type of rock forms? You can directly answer it to the sedimentary rock forms. Now we can see the different types of sedimentary rocks. What are all the different types of sedimentary rocks? Here the types, if you compare the clastic rocks, we'll see these are formed by older rocks accumulation one after other. The old rocks keep accumulating, and also it has silicate minerals and rock fragments present over it. You can see here in clastic rocks we can find a silicate minerals and also rock fragments found in it. And we can see the types of clastic rocks, which means a sandstones and shale. I will show the images for you, no worries my dear friend. And here you can see the image how this sedimentary rocks are formed. Here you can see one of the other lines are found here, which means one after other the sand and particles keep accumulated over and over, and slowly they form into rocks. And here you can see the different rock forms. Shale means how it looks like, and sandstone means how does it look like. And okay, we'll move on to the topic. Wait a bit. Yeah, here you can see sandstone and shale. Yes, shale, as I shown here, shale is here, sandstone is here. How does they look like? And next, chemical rocks. If you come to the chemical rocks, it is due to the chemical precipitation and mineral constitution. Several minerals form solutions, chemicals. So due to the chemical reaction, they keep on changing their structure and slowly form into rocks. So it is of different types, gypsum, nitrates, and barytes. Those things are these types. I think rock salt you can consider as a chemical form, and much more we can find here. Okay, next we can see organic and biochemical rocks. If you compare to organic and biochemical rocks, it is biological reaction that had creating the rock forms due to the accumulation of a rock, mostly organic matter. So accumulation of the organic matter leads to the formation of organic rock forms, and also it is due to the high pressure. You can see here high pressure is over and over laid down on the rocks, so it forms as biological rock forms. And also we shall see the types of biological rock forms. Here mostly we are using a fossil fuel. Coal is a fossil fuel, and also here limestone and also chalk. These are all the forms of biological rocks or organic rock forms that we have been seeing earlier. Here you can see the limestone, how does it look like, conglomerate and chert. These are all the sedimentary rock forms. Hope you understand how these sedimentary rock forms are created and formed. And next we can see the metamorphic rocks. Before seeing metamorphic rocks, it is a transition between the sedimentary and igneous rock. See here, sedimentary rocks due to high pressure and temperature, it forms into the metamorphic rocks. And also again these metamorphic rocks becomes a molten lava due to high temperature, and again this cools and solidifies into igneous rocks. So it will be correlated, and also these igneous rock again it will be weathered and formed as sedimentary rocks. This is a what a cyclic process of rock formation is happening, which we had seen in the first image itself. Next we can see these metamorphic rocks formations. If you come to the formation of the metamorphic rocks, what does that happen here? Here igneous or sedimentary rocks, both any of the rock if you consider, they go through a metamorphic process. What is that metamorphic process? It is also called as metamorphism. What is it? It is a high pressure and temperature, high temperature and pressure. In your exam they can ask what is a high metamorphism happens. Otherwise, metamorphism is a process of, it is a process of going through high temperature and pressure. You must be able to answer that thing. Here you know how the thing goes on. Next we can see here, what are the metamorphic rocks formation based on the other values. See, clay is formed into due to high temperature and pressure. How this they form? Clay is formed into slate, coal due to high temperature and pressure form into graphite, limestone form into marble, and also granite form into gneiss, and also sandstone forms into quartzite, shale forms to schist. See here, these things are most important to remember for your exams, because based on these values some of the questions can be asked, because they will be asking questions such that the granite goes through high temperature and pressure, and how does it forms? It forms to the gneiss. This is the way you must be able to answer. And also metamorphic rocks, if you consider, it has two types of rocks. Mostly it is a foliated rocks and also non-foliated rocks. Foliated rocks means it will be like a rack arrangements one after other. Let me show you the image also. Here we shall see the metamorphic rock varieties. Here quartz, slate, marble, serpentine, schist and gneiss. You can look over the images so that you have an image, but better than that you can remember the value, what are the rock forms. And here I'll show you the foliated rocks and non-foliated rocks. Foliated rock means it will be like one after other, it will be sheet like divisions will be present, and also non-foliated rock you won't find such things. Okay friends, I hope you had clear understanding of the rock forms and rock formations. Thank you friends, thanks for watching SPB Education World. Together we create a better world. If you are not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe to our channel, and also keep supporting. Don't worry my dear friends, here Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English, four languages classes will be available, so don't get bit confused. If you kindly watch our playlist so that you'll be getting all the courses that are required for your exam. I'm this SP Rajan, taking for you classes in Tamil, Telugu, four and Hindi, English, four languages, so it may take time on these things. Don't get bit confused, you'll be having a clarity over the topic. So I had created a playlist in a clear sense. And also if you wanna share with your friends, you can share, and also you can contribute through crowdfunding so that we can reach out to the many peoples and many students, and we can help much more people, my dear friends. Those who are supporting and subscribe, thank you. Thanks for supporting. Bye, take care. Signing off, SP Rajan.